Hey everyone, I thought I would film a daily makeup routine video for you all. I've been wanting to do one for a while now but haven't had the time, so I thought now, as I've got a few minutes, I'll sit down and record it. Finally. So first, I always start with my base, which for me is my simple moisturiser. I just use a small dollop and make sure I rub it all over my face and all the way down onto my neck, and it creates this really nice, I would say it's quite a natural base. I can't wear anything too heavy as this makes my skin oily, and I can't wear anything that is super, super, super thin as my skin stays dry, as I have really annoying combination skin. So I found that the best moisturizer for me was this Simple Moisturizer, as it's got that in-between texture, would you say texture? Like, balance, like it's nicely balanced between making my skin hydrated and not oily, and hydrated enough to not be dry. After I've used my moisturizer, I go in with the concealer. I actually newly bought this concealer. It is the number 7 concealer in Cool Ivory. I've only been using this for about 2 weeks. I'm really liking it. It can come up a little bit dry if you don't have a dewy finish foundation, whereas I do have a dewy finish foundation, so I find it okay. It's really nice. I use it, if I have really red areas, I'll use it twice over the same area or just apply it quite heavily the first time round. I like to use it on my tip of my nose, like you can see. I always get a red nose. I don't know what it is. I'm like Rudolph or something. That's the number 7 in Cool Ivory that I use. Now next, after I've applied the number 7 concealer, I bought this like Charlotte Tilbury The Retoucher Conceal and Treat Stick. I don't really know what you're supposed to do with this. I'm gonna be completely honest with you. Like, I really don't know. I think you're meant to put it under your eyes, so that's what I do anyway. I don't even know what it does. Like, I don't have bags under my eyes, but I just feel like because I've got it and I spent a lot of money on it, I think it was like 20 something quid. I was like, right, I've got to use it. So I just put it on under my eyes. If someone can actually tell me what I could use this for, I'd be grateful. I got told to use a beauty blender to apply my foundation with. So that's what this is. It's a beauty blender on a stick. I got it from Boots for like $4.99. And I am literally in love with this little tool. It's so good. I don't know if I'm using it right. Like, I don't think you're meant to smear it. I think you're meant to dab it onto your face. But I just feel like that takes too long. So I tend to smear it all around and then dab it in to set it. So after I've used both concealers, I then move on to my foundation. Now, I have to tell you, this is the best foundation I've ever used in my entire life. I am in fucking love with this foundation. It is the Giorgio Armani Foundation in Luminous Silk, and it's in shade 5.5. It is a little bit dark for my skin tone, but I decided to go for a shade darker as I thought, well, I'm gonna be getting a suntan if we ever receive any sun in England. This foundation is a dewy finish, and I absolutely love it because it is very buildable. I always just wear a small amount. I do one squirt of it on one cheek and one squirt of it on the other cheek, and then spread that around my face. So it really makes your skin look nice and plump. I think it doesn't make it look dry in any way whatsoever, which is what I struggled with the Charlotte Tilbury foundation. It dried out my skin. I would highly recommend this foundation, but if you do prefer a more of a matte finish, Giorgio Armani do one that's like power fabric foundation, and that has the matte finish if that's what you desire. Now, this bronzer I've had for quite a long time, as you can see. It's the MUA. I think it says Makeup Academy. So, Makeup Academy Bronze Perfection in Sunset Tan. I really like this bronzer just because it's just simple. It's not like one that has like two shades, and I always worried that I'm gonna like get more of the darker shade than the light shade. It's just like one matte color. I use it very lightly, as you can see. I just do this like 3 shape on either side of my face, as my mum told me to do that. She just said that's what you're meant to do with it, so that's what I still do with it. And then I use the excess all on my neck and on my bridge of my nose and on my forehead, kind of like where the sun would hit. I suppose it wouldn't even hit. I don't know why I even do it on my forehead, actually, because I have a fringe. After my bronzer, I go in with my blusher. Now I use the like Bourjois Paris blusher in shade Radiant Rose, and it's number 15. And it comes with this really cute little brush inside. I've been using this blusher for, not gonna lie, like 5 years. I don't know, it's like it doesn't go down, and it's still perfect inside. I haven't got a clue what's going on. It's lasting me forever. Like, I would 110% buy this one again because of how long it's just lasted me. This color's really nice. It's just that nice pinky shade, and it blends really well afterwards, and that's what you want. You don't want these two big harsh lines on either of your cheeks. So I really like this blusher. There's not much else to say about it, really, other than it's fantastic. This brush that I use, my mum gave me. I ain't got anything special to say about it because I don't know what type of brush it is. I think it's just a powder brush, so yeah, that's the brush I use. Now this is the bit that I would say makes my daily makeup routine look stand out from the rest, is that I don't use, I suppose, your traditional highlighter. I use glitter. I just love glitter. I didn't intentionally buy it and use it for it to look like highlighter. I have so many different shades of glitter for my face. Like, I have this iridescent one, which is really pretty too. But this is the one I use every day, usually. And it's just a silver gel glitter. I just get a little bit on my finger and apply it onto my cheekbones and over the bridge of my nose. And I kind of get like glittery freckles. But I will say that on the video, it doesn't look as intense as it does in real life. In the video, it just looks like a sparkly highlighter, but in real life, you can tell it's glitter. So if you're watching this video and thinking you want to do it, just make sure to begin with that you want it to look like glitter and not highlighter, because otherwise you will be stuck with just a glittery face and hating it, because it doesn't come off without water. So this is how I achieve my fairy look, because everyone says I look like a little fairy princess with my glitter on. The first set of mascara I use is the Charlotte Tilbury Full Fat Lashes in shade Glossy Black, obviously. I don't know who uses brown mascara or blue. Maybe you could wear blue like you did back in year 10 with your Dream Matte Mousse foundation. I so used to do that as well. The Full Fat Lashes mascara by Charlotte Tilbury is amazing at separating the lashes. I hate clumpy lashes when you've put mascara on, so I really like this as like, I suppose you could say, as a base for my mascara, because it separates the lashes, which means when I go in with my second lot of mascara, it just volumizes them and they've already got that nice length there. Although I will say that it is quite pricey for a mascara. Is it 20? I want to say it's £27. I think it is, but it is quite expensive. It's quite pricey, but I would say personally it is worth the money just for that length and for the fact that it doesn't clump your lashes together. So now I am lining my bottom waterline, is it? I think it's a waterline. Yeah, waterline. I think it's called a waterline. My waterline with the MUA, the Makeup Academy Intense Colour Eyeliner in Snow White. I just find that, my mum told me to do this once again. I feel like my mum should bloody do this video for me. It does look a bit weird now, but when I've put my mascara on my bottom lashes, it does, like, it looks better, basically. I now go in with my second mascara, which is the Maybelline Lash Sensational. This has got rave reviews. Everybody loves it. I feel like I don't even need to talk about it because so many people use this mascara. And I really like the brush on it. It's got like a curved brush where it's thinner on one end and thicker on the other. And I just think it's perfect. This is probably the best mascara I've ever used for volumizing as well. It really gives that fullness and length. And it just sits really nicely on top of the base of Charlotte Tilbury mascara. I rework my lashes for a good probably like 5 minutes, maybe not that long, maybe three to four minutes. I just keep going over them and like separating them and doing my bottom lashes, so I'm just going to skip through that. For my brows, I use the Charlotte Tilbury Legendary Brows in shade Supermodel. Now, I know that a lot of people use this. Well, a lot of people I know use this. It's really good, I think, if you already have nice shaped brows and they're quite full already, like they're quite thick, and you've got quite a bit of hair there, which I feel like my eyebrows do. I mean, they're not the best by any means, but they're not to the point where I need to like properly fill them in with a pencil. This is that really nice in between. It just makes like the hairs look longer and it fills them in and makes them look darker. And that's basically all I need for it, really. The only bit that I need to apply a little bit more heavily is in the middle, like on the bridge of my nose, like those hairs there. They're not on my bridge of my nose, obviously, but like the bits that are closest to the bridge of my nose, like the corners of my eyes. Fuck, I'm just rambling. But basically, yeah, I have to apply it more heavily there because it's a bit really sparse there and they all like poke up, so I have to like fill it in a little bit there. It is worth the price, I would say, because it does the job. I'm not buying loads of eyebrow pencils or eyebrow gels for £3 over the space of a month. I've just bought the one. Now the look is near enough finished, I go in with this white eyeshadow. This eyeshadow is from like Fix It or something. I can't really remember the name of it, but you can pick up a white shadow anywhere. This is in the colour Frosted White, and it's kind of like a shimmery white. I go over my eyelids with it. Again, it just opens up my eye and kind of balances out that white waterline that I've done. So this is my finished look. It's really quick, as you can see, and it literally takes me 20 minutes to apply in the morning. I just really think it makes me look like a nice cute fairy. And that's why I do it every single day. I really hope you like this video. Like, tell me if you want any more, or tell me if I was really fucking shit and I should never do this again. But hopefully you enjoyed it, and I've given away my secrets of where I got my glitter from. It's literally, by the way, I forgot to mention, it's literally like £2.99 from eBay. Right, take care everyone, see you later, bye!
Okay.